This episode of DNews is brought to you by the Buy Power Card from Capital One. Every purchase brings you closer to a new Chevrolet, Buick, GMC, or Cadillac vehicle. Is it just me, or are more people allergic to peanuts now than ever before? What is going on? Why are we allergic to these little things? Hey everybody, thanks for watching DNews. Hi, I'm Trace. Peanuts are delicious. They're free on airplanes, and though I am not a huge fan of peanut butter unless it's on a Granny Smith apple, it's a very popular thing here in the US. Please don't crucify me for not loving peanut butter, it's weird. And yet, peanut allergies are becoming an epidemic. Or maybe they're not, and we're just freaking out. Humans do that, right? Firstly, there are two negative ways that your body can react to food, an allergic reaction or an intolerance. An intolerance is like indigestion or heartburn. Your body isn't happy with the food you've consumed, but it's not dangerous. The vast majority of people who react to peanuts and other foods have an intolerance. If you eat a peanut accidentally and you don't feel very well and you don't die, you are probably intolerant and not allergic. The FDA says 90% of all food allergies are caused by milk or dairy, eggs, certain fish and shellfish, wheat, soybeans, tree nuts, and the magic peanut. If you accidentally eat even a tiny bit of these things and you are actually allergic, you could have a severe reaction that happens right away. Allergies are your immune system freaking out and attacking what it thinks to be a pathogen. Though food allergies are a growing problem, only 8% of children have them overall. And of those, less than 40% react severely. According to a 2010 study by Mount Sinai Hospital, only 1.4% of children were allergic to specifically peanuts. And other numbers that I read are even lower. Pollen, by contrast, affects as many as 1 in 5 people, or 20%, according to the Asthma and Allergy Foundation. But of course, pollen doesn't cause anaphylaxis, or a potentially fatal immune reaction that can be so strong that it inhibits breathing. The CDC, though, says that deaths are really rare from anaphylaxis, only 17 people from 1979 to 1995. Way fewer than died from even lightning strikes. That being said, we are getting more allergic to things. It's growing. The number of people allergic to peanuts has tripled since the late 70s, and scientists don't even know why. Even still, they're working on solutions. A 2014 study in the journal JAMA Pediatric found if moms consumed peanuts while pregnant, the kid in the womb had a much lower risk of developing a peanut allergy. Perhaps part of the rise is because moms are eating fewer peanuts? I don't know. Scientists figure the early exposure to tiny levels of peanut proteins will help prep the developing fetus so they don't freak out when they meet them on the outside. But again, they aren't really sure. Since we know the allergic population is growing, there are lots of steps being taken to protect kids. A University of Florida study this week found pulsing UV light onto peanuts eroded the allergen proteins ARA, H1, H2, and H3 to a, quote, undetectable level. According to the report, they can cut the allergens in a peanut, so 95% of people with allergies would be safe. It might be kind of extreme sounding, but it could mean a lot for the peace of mind at a school cafeteria. In the end, kids can and often do grow out of their youthful allergies, though there are schools that have already banned peanut butter, much to the chagrin of the American Academy of Allergy, Asthma, and Immunology, the Food Allergy and Anaphylaxis Network, and other parents whose kids aren't allergic. They all agree that bans aren't the answer. It's better to treat each child with their individual allergy symptoms as those symptoms arise. Are you allergic to peanuts or are you intolerant? What do you think is causing all of these food allergies? Lacey's video on some other weird ass allergies is over there, so go check that out. And make sure you go down into the comments and let us know about your peanut thoughts. Make sure you subscribe too. Thanks for watching. This episode of DNews was brought to you by the Buy Power Card from Capital One. Every purchase brings you closer to a new Chevrolet, Buick, GMC, or Cadillac vehicle.